My name is Hadley Bergstrom, and we're at the NIAAA in Rockville, Maryland. And I study how habits are formed. So all the way from, you know, habits like tying your shoe to driving a car. These are the type of memories that I'm interested in. I'm learning about how they're formed in the brain, and especially related to disorders such as addiction and also post-traumatic stress disorder. So I'm actually from a small rural town in Oregon. Extremely small town, and both my parents are not scientists at all. In fact, my mother is an elementary school teacher and my father is an art teacher at a middle school. I always wanted to be a scientist. When I was a little kid, I actually used to cut up plastic jugs and put them together and pour different colors of water through them so that it would kind of create kind of a scientific kind of toolbox. I took a job as a research technician out of my undergraduate college years. And
in Oregon.
And I remember I ran my first experiment by myself, and we had results, and the experiment didn't work. It actually failed, but it kind of led us in a new direction. And I had so much fun with that, and I think from that point on, I love being in the lab and running experiments and doing what I do. I look at very small structures in the brain called spines, and these spines are thought to store memory. And so what I do is I take very detailed measurements of these spines, and I link that with different types of learning and memory in the brain. What we're looking at is a reconstruction of a brain and different parts of the brain that are thought to store memories. I took a brain and I digitally reconstructed different aspects of this brain, and from this model I can get different measurements, and then I apply some mathematics. So I can understand, so what we know from this is that different types of learning and memory can actually alter the brain in different ways. I do lots of microscopic work, both using lasers again, a laser microscopy, a fluorescent microscopy, and light microscopy. We're looking at a brain with cells that are lit up using what's called a green fluorescent protein. And so this allows us to look at the structure of the cells, the anatomy of the cells. And from this, we can, again, take measurements and see if there are differences in the overall structure of the cells that relate to different stages of learning and memory. On a daily basis, you're doing something that no one else is doing, possibly in the world. And you're making discoveries that may have profound impact on human civilization, essentially. And you're working with great people. There's quite a bit of collaboration that occurs. So what I'm doing is I'm testing the output of this laser. This is a blue light laser, obviously. It's 473 nanometer wavelength light. And what we can do is we can see how much is the very tip output of this laser. Here it's at about 12 milliwatts, which is quite high. This is a good wavelength light for activating channel rhodopsin in the brain. So that's the next experiment we're going to try. Stay curious. Stay curious in your surroundings. You will run into problems along the way, and in fact, if you don't, that would be a weird thing. You want to stay persistent in what you do, and good outcomes will happen.